So I bought this thing in Bellefonte, Pennsylvania, from this old farmer with this high-pitched voice. You kids are crazy! You're taking that back to Pittsburgh? I thought you said Pittsburgh, which is 10 miles down the road. That's 2.5 hours away. You kids are crazy. You're never going to make it there. Well, we decided, you know what? Screw it. We're going to trust it. And then we eventually got it home. But anyway, I had hopes and dreams of taking this thing, you know, all over the country, California, down south, up north, everywhere you can think of. It actually hasn't made it out of my yard. My dad's all bitching. Get rid of that damn thing. It's got to get out of here, piece of shit. I'm like, all right, fine. We got to have fun with it. So we actually had fun with it. You know, it's worth every $1,500 I paid for it. We've gutted it now. And my dad also said that Exhibit A, the chicken coop, he wants the cage to be taken off of it. So I think, oh, well, we can't get the whole cage as it stands over to the fire pit because it's heavy. So we're going to break it up. Well, what better way to break it up than to drive the RV through it as fast as we possibly can? It just seems logical, right? So we protect the driver. I put that wire there. And we'll see what happens.
What we're about to do here is we're getting ready for Pennsylvania Sledding 2. This time it's a little bit bigger. Instead of a Toyota Tercel, we're using a 25-foot Winnebago Itasca. So what we have here is the old chicken coop. Now what we're doing with this particular section is we're building an enclosed pavilion for the pig roaster so that we have a permanent place for it. We don't have to move it around. It's good for the parties. Now this shed attached to the side here is staying. So this particular piece here, the chicken enclosure with the wire, ends right here. So using a pickup truck, we're going to drag this section out into the middle of the yard, further away. Now it's not actually attached, there's no disassembly required. What we're gonna do is try to get this out for more of a straight shot. I'm removing some chicken wire panes here from the side, and we're going to screw this over the windshield to protect us from flying debris that may come up when the Winnebago, under the power of its General Motors 454 engine, will come colliding sharply into this and hopefully make a pretty good explosion.
Still running, what else can we run over?
I say we just hit this from another angle right here.